different, and we need to understand those differences and how they impact on our health. When a doctor diagnoses a patient with a given disease, the first question that patient has is, what's going to happen to me? At the moment, that doctor can't answer that question properly. All he can tell them is what happens to the typical patient with that disease.
Precision medicine is the promise of giving the right treatment to an individual patient at the right time.
So in my field, which is inflammatory bowel disease, around 40% of patients fail to respond to the treatments that are available.
In complex diseases like immune-mediated diseases, one size doesn't fit all. So we need precision medicine to tailor the treatment better and to get the best outcome possible for our patients.
Precision medicine enables us to treat our patients efficiently, to not have to cycle through drug after drug in order to get response.
We cannot treat all patients with one size fits all. We'll need to develop different treatment for different patients based on their immunophenotyping and characteristics. And that will not happen without a precision medicine approach in which all of us should contribute.
I think we realize that there is going to be some cost to help us implement precision medicine, but ultimately it will reduce costs, certainly be more cost effective, the right drug to the right patient at the right time.
To make this a reality, what we need is investment in basic research that allows us to redefine pathology at a molecular level.
We need a lot of data, big data. And the only way to get that is to study large cohorts and do that in international cooperation. I don't see any other solution.
I think that hospitals should put more efforts into integrating all the data they are generating, you know, following all these patients, the clinical data, the biological data. They should put more efforts into integrating this data in a format that can then be queried.
The key to precision medicine is collaboration. It's really about collaborating across different specialties in medicine, but also across the borders of professions.
The cluster PMI is unique because you have excellent scientists who know how to generate the data and understand and interpret that, as well as excellent clinicians who have access to patient cohorts, and that combination makes it especially strong.
At the same time, there's a clear focus on inflammatory diseases. On the other hand, there's a very broad approach. So the cluster is looking at disease overarching mechanisms and takes advantage of knowledge from different types of inflammation.
The costs associated with drug developments continue to rise. We have an aging population. We have much more chronic diseases. To tackle this, we are going to need precision medicine.
The field of precision medicine is accelerating at pace and will continue to do so as technologies advance.
50 years ago, we would not have even dreamt to be where we are now.
This is obvious. I mean, to me, it's so obvious. Precision medicine is the future.